New concerns today from three big automakers about ethanol and how it affects your vehicle.
Now, the EPA plans to allow gasoline that contains up to 15% ethanol. Marcus McIntosh has been speaking to local auto dealers, some of whom welcome the increase. Marcus?
Kevin and Cynthia, the three automakers were talking about Ford, Chrysler, and Toyota. Although I was unsuccessful trying to talk to anyone on the national level, today we spoke to a local Toyota dealer and a local Ford dealer who can't wait for E15 to hit the pumps.
Well, it's good news because 15% ethanol is going to produce that much less money spent on petroleum products in our country.
Steve Lupke, Vice President and General Manager of Toyota of Des Moines, welcomes word. The Environmental Protection Agency plans to allow gas containing up to 15% ethanol, not just for what it means to his sale of cars, but to the state of Iowa in general.
Think about our Iowa economy. Think about the Iowa farmer. 20% of all of the Iowa corn was spent basically on ethanol production last couple of years. And this year, it's been doubled already.
Between 125 and 150.
That same sentiment is shared by the general sales manager at Noble Ford in Indianola. Despite the fact Ford is not so sure E15 will be compatible with cars dating 2001 or newer, Pattinson says this does not come without risks.
A lot of the ethanol you find in stations now is E10, and that's pretty much good for everything up to then. That higher alcohol content, can cause internal engine damage over a prolonged period of time.
That seems to be one of the main concerns for the big three automakers, damage to vehicles down the line. Monty Shaw with the Iowa Renewable Fuels Association is supremely confident that E15 fuel is no more a danger to your vehicle than the gas at the pump right now.
There's no evidence, there's not a single study that's been done that would show that E15 would affect the normal wear and tear on your car.
So all the people we spoke with today expect to see the E15 option in the coming months. As for the possibility of E20, E25, or E30...
It's hard to say where that's going to go. Anytime you get government agencies involved, about anything could happen.
Now, the key here is that E15 blend gasoline has been approved by the Environmental Protection Agency. It is not required. So retailers have to choose to sell that blend when it is available, and, of course, consumers then have to choose to buy it. Kevin?
All right, Marcus, thank you very much for that.